We'll be right back. Miami. See ya. We haven't had the opportunity to play for you for a long time, so thanks for making us feel so welcome. Mike McCready has not thrown a pick out in Miami since 1994, so he's got some making up to do, right?
Talk goes through all the walls in Pompeii now. Oh, look at him drawing circles down. Falling orbs out my hidden ground. Oh, talking about
I'm
It took a, you know, I want to clarify, we weren't doing, I mean, all the power to him, but we didn't mean to come off like Guns N' Roses, not starting right at 8 o'clock. It just took a while to get everybody in. I guess there was traffic. You know. But it's, it's always nice when they say, oh, don't worry, because the building has no curfew and it's a late night town. So it's all good. Thank you. this is Pete the Englishman. Hey, Pete. This song was, I think we were all about 25 when we wrote this song. Which is about how old the song is, which is crazy. Let's play the shit out of it anyway. Greg McCready on the Fender Stratocaster. Well, sure, it's a nice building. We want to thank Dwayne Wade for the nice invitation that he sent us. And you know, Jeff, we didn't get to play basketball, but we still got to play the venue. This is pretty, it's all right. And Chris Bosh, what a great guy. What a great guy. Good fan. And Pat Riley used to coach the team, right? That was good. And he likes music. And I'm just, we better have, you know, maybe we'll have to come back in, you know, 5 or no longer than 10 years, because after that, apparently this place is going to be underwater up till about the 3rd level there. But I hear your governor has that all under control, because he looks like he's got it all. I put my faith in him. This here song's called Infallible. Yeah. Mr. Stone Gossard on the guitar right now.
You.
Songs by Dead Moon. I don't know if you know that.
Dead Moon.
And I'd like to send this one out to Fred and Tootie. And I loved Andrew the drummer.
Hold on.
we get a shot of these? There's a couple of fine-looking fellas right in front there. Can you see them? Is there enough light there? That's an interesting way to request a song. Can you see them? There you go. Now I'm thinking that we might have to honor this request only because, I mean, these fellas here, they know when they do that, there's no chance in hell, even in Miami at spring break, that they are getting laid tonight. So I think we should probably play a song, and I'm more worried about the man on the right who's going to be walking around all night with Christ written on his head. And some kind of crazy tattoo. So, do you have your mom's number so you can call her from jail? If not, I'll give you mics. And this here song's called Tremor Christ for these fellas.
Round the world to save the world. But somehow still lived on. I
good? Everybody good? Maybe stick around for a little bit. Happy birthday to that man right there. And what's that next one? Your penis is folding. You gotta erect it. 35th birthday, 50th PJ show. State of Love and Trust. We got you. Happy birthday. You don't look 50. Everybody good in the back and the top and the. I've had the honor and privilege, and it's something that I hold very close to me, is a friendship I have with a person who's just such a great, great songwriter and great person and great musician, performer, singer. And I think this is her hometown now. And if you've heard some of, I've sang on maybe one of her records, and she sang on some ukulele songs with me, and her name's Shawn Marshall. You might know her as Cat Power. I love you, Shawn. And this song is an important one. Someone Someone came to, a friend of my brother's came to the show last night, and he said, I just can't believe how many, just such cool people come to the show. So, he saw so many cool people last night. And I guess we get kind of used to it, so it was nice to be reminded. But, you know, you do go to other events sometimes, and you'd be surrounded by complete fucking knuckleheads, you know. And I don't know what our part was in that, but we're real proud of it. And you know, it feels like, you know, not to overblow it, I probably shouldn't even be talking about it, but a sense of community is something very powerful. And we're very grateful. There's always going to be someone in the community who takes his shirt off in public, and, you know, it's always going to be. But we all get along, you know? It's great. It's great. Man, if I wasn't married. And my wife and I, and she's done amazing work. There's a skin disease called epidermolysis bullosa. You can look it up on EBRP. We're making real strong headways connecting doctors and researchers, and it's an incredibly diabolical disease that kids have and young people have. Affects their skin and their internal organs, and it's brutal, but we're really onto something, and we've been making big donations lately and raising some funds in the last few years, and I'm mentioning it tonight because somebody just out of the blue came up to my wife and wrote us a check for $10,000, so we're very, very grateful for that. Now, somebody in our community, there was a husband named Tony and a wife named Diane, and the cure for breast cancer isn't there yet, and that's how he lost his dear wife very recently. And Tony's here tonight, and we want to. He used to sing this one to her, so we're gonna sing it for you.
Just understand that every life must be at home. As we sit alone, I know someday we must go home. Yeah, I'm a lucky man to count on both hands the ones I love. Some folks think I'm wrong, yeah, others think I'm to make me bleed. No one knows this more than me. As I come clean, I wonder every day as I look upon your face, Lord. Everything you gave and nothing you would say, Lord. Nothing you would take. Everything you gave.
This one goes out to an Italian couple. You know who you are, from Milano.
I sure know there was someone else. The hurt don't show, but who knows? Time will tell. Now I believe. I can't.
You guys know Roger Waters, yeah? He does an incredible thing every year. I think he's done it maybe 3 or 4 years. The last one I know was in D.C., and he gets a lot of veterans together and veterans who knew a bit about music or played an instrument at one point, and he works out his own songs with them, and they get to play Pink Floyd songs with Roger. And with, you know, there's, you know, it's just really touching and moving and incredible to see. And they, you know, to see him take a guitar solo in a Pink Floyd song next to Roger. And then he employed other musicians to do their songs. I didn't get to do it last year, but I really am looking forward to it. And I think about it here because you've got more veterans in the state of Florida than anywhere in the United States. And they picked a good spot to come, but it's just really sickening how our government has really failed them with support and different treatment and opportunity to reward them for such incredible selflessness. So a little thing that... $1 of all the shows that we're playing in Florida, all through Florida, will go to local organizations who support the veterans. And and then the other thing that the last time I saw Pink Floyd was actually here in Miami many years ago. So thinking about Roger, thinking about the veterans, we'd like to play this one for you.
Just a little pinprick.
stand on. I do believe it's working good. That'll keep you going through the show. Come on, it's time to go. There is no pain you ought to see. Like distant ships.
Have to take those.
friends is running to get in. Leave a message and we start. Couldn't learn your voice one last time. Daily mind feel is good. Be my time by you. Would you hit me? Would you hit me?
dressed, you guys, the best dressed. With a fancy bow tie right there. They're talking to each other. They're figuring out where they're gonna, if they're gonna get share hotel rooms tonight. I'm just kidding. You look great. Handsome. Cheers. Let's see, what should we talk about? Well, how about that one motherfucker who made it off the thing into the, just like the old days. That was really good. Best part is he didn't get caught. And it reminded me that maybe the last time, because my memory's perfect, maybe the last time we played Miami, it was outside, I want to say it was one of the later shows of the tour, if the last, might have been the last show of the tour. Stone's guitar got stolen, it was a whole thing. But I saw something that, after all those years of early crazy touring, and even other groups, I'd never seen this, so the floor was a baseball field. And you know, there was people crowd surfing everywhere. But they brought a guy up in a wheelchair and passed a guy up in a wheelchair like 50 yards, and he made it to the stage for Rockin' in the Free World. Amazing. He ended up writing a book called Murder Ball, because he stayed an athlete. And his name was Mark Zupan, and I read his book and realized that he had that story in there. I was like, that's the fucking guy. And I also heard that he might be here somewhere tonight. So, Mark, good on you. Start in the back. Speaking of the back, we're going to play one for these fellas. Thank you. One little favor before we continue. We were talking a lot about our crew last night, and we had some sad news about one of our old members, and we wanted to celebrate one of our guys that's been with us from day one, from conception, inception, with no contraception. And with reflection, we realized how important he's been, and if you see the Deep magazine, the latest one, that's all him. He's our archivist, he's our great, great friend. He's dedicated his life to this group. And it happens to be his birthday, and he's not gonna get away without 25 years, no embarrassment. Now's the time, Kevin. Come on up, and we'll say happy birthday to our dear friend, Kevin Shuss. He's mad at me. Let's give it a go to Kevin. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. All right, thank you. Who wants cake? Kevin, if you remember, he was the guy that we made a... Hey, Kevin! You want to make a little extra dough? Remember that one time when we were in Canada and everybody in the band pitched in $500 so we could... But you'd have to wear a mullet for a whole week? And he did it. And it was great. And it was in Canada, so no one knew the fucking difference. Everyone will pitch in 50 cents tonight to see you get a
more... You got deeper pockets now.
So. I got deeper pockets now. He's right. All right, happy birthday, Kev. Thank you for having me.
Drop down, coming down.
tell me.
Yeah. Matt Cameron, Mike McCree, Jeff Haven, Stone Gossett, Neil Young, somebody say.
Stop on garbage for you.
a reunion with Mark. Thanks for everything. Tonight, we'll remember you. Much love. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you.